Hello, everybody who's watching Doom. Go watch Doom.
And we are back trying to finish episode 7.
Butt squids.
Somebody pass me what is called the remote.
Butt squids. Butt squids?
Yes.
I was looking for it because he was asking for it.
All I'm saying is, yes.
Sigma, wake up. Alright, he's awake. He did his eyebrow raise.
Are you going to put me in the robot suit? Are you? Please? Robot suit. Please? No. Who did you upload you into a network that you would hack?
I guess that could be fun too.
This level sucks.
Why are you so angry?
This level's bullshit.
You have the rage of a phantom. Oscar, my.
So, how was everybody's day?
I had a protein shake today.
I thought that's why you were still drinking.
Nah, I just finished it.
You just made it! I saw you just shake it up like 2 seconds ago.
And I walked and drank it.
Alright, Miss Fortune, you should take a protein shake.
I don't work out enough for that yet. I work out, but I don't work out that much yet.
Top is gym obsessed and a meathead.
Not a meathead.
No, he's totally
give him about a week.
Totally meathead. It's already affected his brains.
Use the staff.
Everybody, does anyone else find the fact that you can't pick what episode you want to do in this story mode stupid?
Oh, really?
Talking about outside of private?
Yeah. I just found that really dumb.
Wow, really?
Yep.
That's stupid. Hey, it's gold. My name is Squid.
Who the hell is Nova?
It's the AI.
The AI going to die?
Yeah, the AI can apparently die.
Yep.
Squid.
Yo.
What's with you and your obsession with
squids? He wants a pet squid.
Oh, dude, that'd be awesome.
I'm not getting that. You wouldn't take care of it. And then it's just sitting there staring at somebody wanting food. And I'm like, I don't know what you eat.
Small shellfish and stuff like that.
That's how that requires me to get him food.
I mean, you just go to Walmart and grab one of the lobsters out of there. He's good to go.
Lobster's $15. Nope.
Never mind. That lobster can stay his ass where he at.
He ain't about to eat better than me.
Just go get a citizen snips and drop it in there.
It's going to fight him. And do you want to fight? You want to watch a squid fight a lobster?
There was an entire movie about a squid fighting a giant octopus on Sci-Fi.
It just made it look like the squid was just trying to give the lobster a hug. That's it. That's all it did.
That's how every squid fight looks.
I'm trying to give you a hug. Let me give you a hug.
Let me hug you to death. Everybody knows the best animal to watch fight is a shark versus a whale.
You mean mega shark versus
No, me to watch. Mega shark versus super croc.
That sounds terrible.
It's awesome. The shark can fly.
Sharknado is what you need to watch.
I watched the scene of that thing taking flight, then I stopped watching. This doesn't make sense.
No,
what you want to watch is Ball versus Python.
Yeah, let's not watch that.
Just two snakes slither.
There's a lot of things in life that we should watch. That's not one.
Two snakes slithering all around each other.
No.
I feel like you should try it.
That sounds just wrong.
It is wrong.
Like all types of wrong. This guy's checking his porn.
I'm checking it right now.
Leave him alone.
Why, he got good porn?
Nah, man, he's just minding his own business.
Yeah, trying to beat off while all his comrades are dying.
Oh my gosh.
Spinning Don't top. Listen to it.
Top, you should watch Beyblade Burst.
Yeah, it sounds okay.
It's actually not bad.
That's what I said. It sounds okay.
I don't know. He might not like it.
You're right.
He might not like it. Tyson's not bad.
What? No Fat Tyson.
What else should you do?
How can you have Beyblade without Fat Tyson?
Easy.
He's fat.
He's not needed.
You need Fat Tyson.
His past is prob.
Told you. Tyson did everything awesome. Why? He believed in spinning toys changing the world.
So did Jenga.
No. We're not going to talk about that.
I don't know. I feel like you want some metal fusion in your life.
Not again.
That's what you need.
The voice acting in that whole show makes my brain want to explode.
This is a bad show.
What, metal fusion?
Yes.
I think the tops were pretty lame, too.
None of the tops were interesting. I would give Jenga one thing, though. I liked his special moves. Outside of that, nothing.
I didn't like the fact that his spirit was a Pegasus.
Oh, but you won't like the main character of Burst. It's Valkyrie.
I'm not trying to sound sexist, but is it a girl?
No. It's a dude riding a horse.
Oh. I actually thought of Odin from Final Fantasy when I first saw it.
Oh.
Old man Odin.
I mean, I that sounds like that could be cool.
And his rival has, like, what looks to be Ashura to be his.
And then you have one guy who has a Reaper named Death Scyther. Or was it Death Sizer?
Oh, I missed that one.
I that sounds awesome.
There's also Cerberus.
I don't care for that.
It's a big green doll.
See, I can't care for Cerberus anymore because of Final Fantasy VIII.
That's cool, but the character who has it, he has like two puppets on his hands and they do the talking.
What if Final Fantasy VIII do to Cerberus?
Yeah, Cerberus is lame.
What? How?
All you cast is double and triple.
That's right.
That doesn't sound helpful.
It's not.
It's helpful if somebody knows Ultima.
Yeah, I mean, there's that, but I could do that myself. I'd need a whole animation for you to cast double and triple on me.
But he does it to the whole party.
So? Carbuncle's not even that useful.
Man, Carbuncle does Wonder Guard. You leave him alone.
Yes, Sigma.
No.
Carbuncle's entire thing is not to fight for you.
I was more of a... What? Leave that guy alone.
I think the Bay Battles are dicks, though.
How do they work?
You can win if you break their top.
Oh, that's not cool.
I had to put a golf club on it.
It's the first one to 2 points. You get a spin victory if you make them stop spinning. That's 1 point. Out victory is if they go out the stage. That's 1 point. But if you break their blade, you get 2 points and win automatically.
Yeah, that's not cool.
So the goal is to break the Beyblade. They call it bursty, but I'm like, you just broke my top. This ain't cool.
Dick.
So basically, if I burst your Beyblade...
I automatically win. I don't care if you had 1 point already. I win.
So if I shatter your Beyblade into 1,000 pieces...
I win. It won't shatter. It just breaks into 3 pieces, the standard, you know, click back together things. But still, my top was broken.
But I'm pretty sure someone takes it too far in that show.
It's only got 6 episodes, so...
Somebody will take it too far.
I'm pretty sure someone's going to split a Beyblade in half. And by then, I feel like you should be disqualified. You took it too far.
My blade.
Destroy his Beyblade! Oh. Snap.
And where's the Evil Corporation?
Looks like Miss Fortune's about to die. I haven't seen the Evil Corporation yet.
Oh, I know who it is. People who don't believe in spinning tops. Don't believe in spinning tops,
what's up? Got the WBBA.
Oh, they're back?
Yep.
And the best man, the best announcer ever.
Unbelievable! Seriously, that Japanese man was so into it.
Unbelievable!
Beyblade, Beyblade, let it rip.
Oh, I have completely dished
that.
I dished Umber.
No, I'm just knock people off the edge. Get the fuck out.
Oh, that does sound interesting. I shall watch.
Yeah. The main character is really stupid.
Oh, that's usually how it goes.
No, he's even more stupid and barely knows the basics of Beyblade.
But he's like that instinctual genius.
I get it. It's Goku.
Yeah. If I had to sum it up, yes, that is what he is.
Ah, which means he inevitably has a Vegeta.
Technically, that would be his rival.
It's technically his Vegeta? That's kind of hard to call.
Well, the guy with the Reaper sounds more interesting than all of them.
The guy with the Reaper seems to be more like his Vegeta.
Why? Because he's a man with a Reaper.
Damn, when they had a battle, they bursted each other 11 times straight.
What the hell is with Oscar Mike?
No idea.
Like that guy that killed you? That was me. That was all me.
Here's 11 straight bay battles, bursting each other. So I was like, neat. And then the Japanese man started yelling unbelievable again. So I'm completely okay with that show.
I'll watch it. It's been a while since there's been a good Beyblade show. That Shogun one sucked the most.
You watched that?
What was a Shogun one?
Beyblade Shogun still. Remember that one I told you where it was Jenga was older and it was old, other kids?
Yeah.
That's what it was.
That one was bad.
I tried to watch it. Couldn't get
it. And that Bay Wheels one was dumber than that.
I love the Bay Wheels.
The Bay what?
The wheels. They were wheels. I just find that one funny.
Who told them to be different?
They never made it a full show, though.
I bet you they didn't.
I think it would have done all right.
No.
Would have been better than Shogun Steel.
That one was just bad. It was stupid. The stakes were stupid. Everything was stupid.
How were the stakes stupid?
You could fight. You could bay battle a giant spear.
You could do what?
Yeah.
You were bay battling in a giant spear. And then what made it worse than that was that the spear rotated. So it was like rotating while you were bay battling, and apparently it took a massive amount of skill to be able to bay battle in it, but honestly everybody made it look like a 2-year old could do it.
To die.
You landed in the lava, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
Let's watch his death.
There's no way up. Just die.
You would have had to make it all the way over there.
I mean, right here would have been a good spot. But all the jumps with like no authority whatsoever.
Just let it happen. Oh, don't revive him. Oh, you're a dick.
Run up that hill. No, don't run in the fire. Run on the side. The hell are you doing? Nope.
That was a smart plan, because I thought he was gonna come all the way over here.
But then he didn't.
Just die.
You're supposed to run up there, get a running start, and then jump to this. One of that thing over there, something. Oh, that reminds me. Rook got stuck there.
No, Rook got stuck over here. Rook got stuck over
here. Why do you have...
That should shoot me.
Why do you have the sun out?
I'm about to run forward and kill him.
Yep. Yeah, but when Rook got stuck there, he still couldn't jump up here.
Then how did he get back up?
He jumped back over there.
Over where?
Look at my screen. Over there. From up there. Ran out and jumped on that. That's what I just told him to do, but then he started trying to jump over here. Rook, what the hell are you doing? Why are you up there?
He's special.
Yeah, just gonna let Misfortune die.
Just let him die.
He showed back up all the way down there.
Rook, get him. Pick him back up.
No, just respawn.
I love how Rook got back, though.
Damn. He got back. Jeff. I just left and went in. I don't know what y'all doing.
Can't say I didn't expect you to do that.
Now, there was nothing wrong with the wheels, Beyblade. It was interesting. Different, but interesting. I just want to know how it's going to get very extreme when two wheels rolling down the track. Like, are Bay Spirits going to come out and start trying to headbutt, or are we looking at 5Ds here? A whole lot of nothing going on.
Ah, my heartbeat makes me feel alive.
I missed that throw.
What do we have to kill?
I don't know. I'm killing that thing over there.
Win or lose, just let death.
Ah, we failed.
I can't see you.
Pump a turret.
Temporal.
I'm gonna build an inferno trap here.
Nope.
They want to take you into the great lava abyss.
Let it happen.
Let them take you.
Let it do.
Darkness, hold me.
Let it build.
Let it boom. Shock turret.
Squiggly. Philia.
Girl, girl, Sue would be interesting. But they're not getting that.
What the hell are they gonna do?
No idea.
Let it
they should
build.
Just stay with what they are.
Let it build.
Let it be known that Top is a fan of Yu-Gi-Oh! Arc V.
I am not.
Oh. You don't like the pendulum song, man?
Nah, that shit's broken.
I'm gonna watch that show at some point.
It's really.
And then explain to me what the hell.
I will try my best to explain it to you later.
So the best I understand is that you set the pendulum between two star monsters. They have to be two pendulum monsters, first of all. Once you set it between those two monsters, depending on their star levels, you can summon within that level free of charge. Between those two levels. Free of charge.
Sounds legit.
But do they have to be pendulum monsters?
They have to be pendulum monsters. Can't just be any old willy-nilly monster.
Yeah, that would be cheap. To summon all the pieces of Exodia. I win.
Exodia don't exist anymore.
Why not? Exodia is awesome. Anything that helps you win the game by just having it in your hand is awesome.
The hell is her problem? I got a leg.
You took somebody's leg?
What you playing, Doom?
You do take a lot of legs in Doom.
Dude, that kill is awesome.
You take a lot of dicks, too. Sit there. You rip off the dicks. Okay, wave complete. Are we done here?
No.
I will pick your ear.
Ew.
Got the boost.
Use the map to keep the eye on the enemies.
Your map.
I'm gonna stay at this defense thing to protect it.
Your defense thing.
And me and Rook are just gonna run around.
But you wanna see some action, I guess watch Misfortune's screen. But he's kinda just standing in front of me. Yay?
You can do like commentary.
Miss Fortune, commentate on what's going on.
Well, just a lot of running around from what I can see.
Shank.
But is it a blur in hyperdrive? Take that.
Hey, I didn't say it was good either.
But you have to get hyperdrive commentary.
Okay, let's see. Once per turn during the main phase, turn four has a pendulum monster.
Seriously, where's that one?
In each of their two pendulum zones. Then the turn player can pendulum summon any number of monsters from there. Wait, what the fuck?
That's broken. I heard that. That's broken.
Can do what now?
Okay, so here's how it works. Once per turn, during the main phase, the player has to have a pendulum monster in each of their two pendulum zones. So you have two zones. Two pendulum zones.
The next turn that happens, the player could summon a pendulum monster of any number of pendulum monsters into their hand, or any number of pendulum monsters that are face up in the extra deck, with the level or rank between the blue pendulum monster scale and the red pendulum monster scale.
I need to actually see that before I dub it broken or not, because it sounds broken, but I don't think it is.
Because only monsters of pendulum, only between the levels, can be summoned between the pendulum scales. So, okay.
Because it sounds like you could just not get what you need.
Yeah, I mean, you would have to have an entire deck of pendulum monsters for this to be incredibly broken.
Because all I heard is that I can basically summon a pendulum monster.
Well, after you put two... I mean, you have to wait your turn. You can't just slap down two pendulum monsters.
And then basically, you also have to set up your pendulum, too.
Yeah, so you got to set up your pendulum. They have to both be in the pendulum zone. You got to set it up. Then once you do all that, then... But I got to be quite honest with you. If anybody sits there...
And lets you do it...
Ah!
That's probably the hard part. Getting the monster set up.
Aha!
Sort of like summoning an Exodia?
Yeah.
Obliterate!
But I mean, once it's out there...
You can summon one monster between the two stars. But then again, you also just sacrificed a higher star monster because of the pendulum. So I could have just got my seven star monster, but instead I put my seven star on the pendulum, now I can't use him because he's there.
If he's a pendulum monster.
Yes. So it's kind of like... It's weird. I'm just gonna call it weird. I ain't gonna call it broken. Nope. Not tonight.
Dick.
We have to figure out what the hell it is.
To be honest with you, I don't know if I even.
No, bitch, no.
Because it seems like it could be a really awesome thing
if you know
what you're doing.
Yay!
But it also seems like if you don't know what you're doing,
you're just not gonna get anything,
and you just got humped. So feel like that person would be like, well, blue eyes. That solves my problem. Ah. Seems you've obliterated my deck, sir.
Indeed. Yay, we did it.
So yeah, I don't need to watch it before I even dub it anything. It
doesn't sound the way like it's supposed to work, if that makes sense. Oh look, there's a tutorial video. Because someone needed to know this. Well, I guess if you actually still play Yu-Gi-Oh!
People still play it.
I'm not saying that they don't.
They play it heavily.
Wait, what?
People still play Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah, they do.
Well, you can play pendulum monsters as monster cards or spell cards. There's a serious video for this.
Of course there is. You can make money off of it. I'm pretty sure there's a video for it.
Look at how to base it. The man making money off breaking shit.
I thought I was just being an idiot.
That too.
I'm not being able to kill you, so I'm gonna move over here.
That thing is flying. That thing is flying. It's dead now.
Okay.
Grossy Hunters.
Okay.
Done.
On what? There's nothing here.
Okay.
Did you just say how to penetrate the monster itself?
Pendulum summon the monster itself.
I thought you said how to penetrate. Really, Phoebe? Really? Okay, Phoebe.
All right, this is the hard part. Build all the defenses first.
Naturally. Actually, it might be best to kill the thing that's in your way as you build the defenses. No, just a thought.
I'm trying different traps. Let's try a flash trap.
Temporal's good.
I don't even know what that does.
Me either, but I've seen it kill something. Oh my god! Oh my god!
What?
Shock turret. Oh! Will you stop it like you're a white chick at a black porno?
Oh no, it is broken.
That sounded like it took a lot of setup.
No, it doesn't.
Cause I don't get it.
Alright.
I get the two, the set, I get all that, but I'm trying to figure out, are pendulum monsters themselves broken?
Yes, they have regular attack. Like, there's one of them that has the attack of a blue eyes.
Wait, how do you summon a pendulum monster?
Okay, here's how it works.
Can you only summon them by doing that pendulum stuff?
What, pendulum monsters?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, pendulum monsters can only come out
by using the pendulum.
However, you can sacrifice them and use them as normal cards if you want to.
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
I still don't know. It sounds like going through more trouble to summon something.
As far as I know, all the defenses are up. I'm going to chill on the upstairs floor, though.
Okay, I'm activating it.
I'm chilling upstairs.
Yeah, you can special summon as many monsters as you want once your pendulum is set up. Does not matter about the attack, as long as there are levels between the sets. I like those two magicians, though.
Oh, the Dark Sage is the best magician.
Oh, okay, cool. So other monsters... Oh, it doesn't have to be just a pendulum monster. Oh.
I just keep moving around, rebuilding, and making new things over and over again.
That's
good. There's a lot of things, like... Oh, the big guys are here. Get them.
The walkers are, I think, will really kill it. Everything else is just kind of a distraction.
Oh. Oh. I don't think I want to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Anymore.
There you go.
I don't know about this one, Sydney.
This sounds complicated.
I'm pretty sure you want to play, man. Just make sure you play with Battle City rules.
Yeah, I feel like that's the only safe rules to play with now.
Nah, I told you.
Nah, but these rules are fine.
Best rules, in my opinion, are, what's it called? Duelist Kingdom.
I don't respect those rules.
I like those rules because as long as you can make it somehow relatable in real life, it's okay.
Because I influenced the card game.
Well, Hero, I can see the problem with it, and I can see how it's not fair.
I don't know. I gotta see it in an actual duel.
Maybe after this, you can look at the video he saw.
No, I was listening the entire time. Yes.
It makes sense, but I agree. I have to actually see someone
abuse it.
Yeah, like, use this. Like,
excuse me.
And they think it's sound broken, but then you watch it, it's like,
Yeah, no one thought Dragon Master Knight was broken until somebody saw him be used in a duel.
Yeah. That's how things get bad.
Because I could see how pendulum summoning could be a problem, but I could also see how I could stop you from doing this. Because technically, if you're like, oh, I'm going to place You could, okay, yeah, you could place two pendulum monsters down on your first go. However,
you have no monsters to defend yourself.
Yeah, you have no monsters to defend yourself, so I could just beat the heck out of you. There's always that option. So, opportunely, to use this right, you would need more than one pendulum monster. So you could set the scale at all time, but you would need more than one. Now, I'm pretty sure there's going to be a restriction on it. Like, you can only have two in your deck. See how? Whole damn deck of pendulum monsters could be a problem. That. But you can special summon as many monsters.
I have been killed.
Did you go out fighting?
They ran up on me.
But you can special summon as many monsters as you want during your main phase.
So I can summon six.
Yes.
I summon my entire deck.
And while you're doing that, it makes it easier to do synchro summons, polymerizations, and pretty much everything.
What is a synchro summon?
I still haven't even learned that one.
Synchro what?
Synchro summon.
And synchro what?
And there's another one called exceed summoning now.
Yep, don't know what that is either.
I'm just going to watch the show.
Now I decide you're making shit up.
I'm just going to watch the show.
You are making shit up.
The show will teach me.
Watch 5D so you can know what it is?
No, I already know what synchro summoning is.
Then what the hell is it?
It's when you use a synchro monster, i.e. I'm going to use Jump Tuner, for instance. And that Jump Tuner will take that monster to its next evolution, essentially.
Oh, so it evolves the monster.
In a way, for some cards. And sometimes it's just you summon another monster.
So the only one we don't know is Exceed Summoning.
I feel like that's in, the one after you said...
Get septic, get decked, motherfuckers!
What's wrong with his hair?
You talking about Zexel?
Yeah, I feel
no
like...
No one likes Zexel.
I don't know what the hell Zexel is about.
No one likes him.
I've been here the whole time. I do not know where that damage came from.
Some people can attack for
Oh, here it is. Exceed summon. Yep. XYZ. It was in Zexel.
Yep.
God damn.
Wow, Exceed Summon cards look awesome.
Yeah, they do. This Zexel's one. RV's card looks more kitty.
In my opinion, it was him. He made it, boy.
Yeah, Exceed Summon looks like the cards are black.
I think there's two of them over here. Yeah. Two of these big ones.
Take note of that. I'm kind of trying to kill the things at the front door that have, like, ranged attacks.
Get away.
Fuck.
Oh, they call it XYZ summoning.
Get away.
XYZ summoning.
That's stupid. Barrel Walker. Stabbing it in the butt.
Ah, killed it. No, you don't. No, you don't, you little fucker.
Let's see. During the phase, one or two of the games starts over. The player can declare...
Why can they teleport?
XYZ monster.
I'm not escaping.
They intend to XYZ summon. If they stack the required XYZ materials on top of a single monster in the monster zone, as listed, the XYZ monster will know. Okay.
Seriously, this bitch has been... That bitch ran from me.
Oh, that's how it works. You stack them on top of each other.
What the hell is that? Oh. There's one more somewhere.
Yeah, dude, the cards are black and it's so cool. XYZ effect. And the player declares into... Oh, okay, I get it.
Oh, I thought we were all gonna die.
So. Oh, that's easy.
You had to say something!
Oh, okay, cool. That looks destructive. What is that?
I don't know, but real quick.
It has two swords.
I'm gonna name him Chari.
See, this is when you should have. Hero, this is when you should have had Wraith. You could have dueled him.
Oh, man.
A lot of things could have happened. You know what's about to happen, though?
Shank him.
Run! Panic and run!
Stab him in the dick.
Where is he?
Panic and run. Upstairs. Jank.
Why are you following me? You're supposed to scatter. That's how zebras do it. Follow me.
Oh, he has a shield.
Somebody figure out math.
You figure out math.
No. That requires knowledge on math. Destroy his minions?
Destroy these probe-looking things.
I'm dropping a nuke. Fuck it. He can't take any damage.
Of course, because he has...
I'm gonna set this trap.
He's just
gonna
destroy it.
That's fine.
Second he wakes up.
It's a distraction.
Wake up. Wake up.
Oh. Oh, well, it sees something that seems a little bit more fair. I don't know if I would do that, though.
It sounds tough.
What, exceed something?
Yep. Shield again.
Basically, let's say, what's your favorite monster card?
The Dark Magician.
Okay. Let's say the Dark Magician is a XYZ monster. Okay, so basically, you put him in your extra deck, right? And you say, once he's in that extra deck, you'd be like, I could summon him, but I have to set it up. So you would need a monster, well, if his requirements say you need a monster, you need two monsters of level 2 or level 4 to do this. What you would do is you would stack one month. Let's say you would put down Luster Dragon, and then you would put down Gaga Magician on top of him. But when you do that, you have to summon them like normal cards. But once you put one on top of them, the other card can't attack. It's just there. So it's just standing there.
So basically, I have to stack one monster down.
Then stack another. And then you can do it.
And then I can bring out the Dark Magician.
Yes.
Damn.
That's tricky.
Because it can clearly just kill that thing that can't defend itself.
Exactly. I mean, you can defend it all day, but...
It can still be killed. And it can't do nothing else. But
that's why I said to properly do it, you kind of have to...
Got him.
Set it up for that. To properly do it. That's tricky, though. I wouldn't mind doing that. That seems like that could be fun. I see Sigma doing this.
Oh, I feel like I'm about to blow up. I don't know, I just feel like the shit was about to blow up and fall now. This is like mission.
Boom!
Oh, you can stack them up in defense too.
I figured that one. Yeah. They still can't do nothing.
Yeah, they still can't do shit.
I'm a sitting duck.
Yeah, pretty much. Your card is just sitting there. What are you doing? Nothing. Why do you keep... Nothing. Why are you just stacking cards? Don't look over here. Don't look at them. Fight that monster right there. Look at him. Don't look at them.
He's menacing Eddie. Look at him. Summon this thing. This bigger thing.
Oh, damn. And once they're out there, you cannot move them. Once you stack it, that's it.
I have unlocked Atticus.
I got gold. And I think I just unlocked Galilee.
Oh, no. And if they're destroyed, that monster plus the monster you stacked on it goes to the graveyard.
So basically, I can easily just destroy your entire stack.
Hey, you just lost two monsters.
Sounds great.
Sounds like a fun mechanic. I'd use that one.
I don't know. I'm still
sick. Yeah, I got a new skin for all
Battle City.
But that one's fun. We can use that one. That one's not broken.
Or Duelist Kingdom. Duelist Kingdom is good.
So I'll get back to you once I get episode 16 in Part B.
Yeah, once you get there, you let me know exactly how this Pendulum Summoner works out. But I
feel like this is some way to completely ruin your pitching.
I swear, I feel like all you gotta do is just kick him in the knee right when it's happening.
Last Pendulum Summoner.
Bam! Oh!
My plan!
Well, I mean, you could just use a Harpy's Feather Duster, and that pretty much eliminates their whole plan.
That eliminates everybody's whole plan.
That's why you're only allowed one of those in the deck.
Because, I mean, you can use that, or you can use the Mystical Space Typhoon, or... Pretty much just use anything that destroys magic cards. Because when you put a pendulum monster in the pendulum zone, it's a magic card.
Yep. But we beat episode 7. Join us for the final episode on advanced mode. I unlock the characters I want.
And as we discover more about Yu-Gi-Oh!
See you later. Rook, say goodbye.
He put his penis on the camera. I saw it.